Alright guys, so the first comment on today's video is going to receive themselves a rare box. These things are absolutely mad. They give some insane rewards. I just got a 30s plate leg out of one. Like, what? Okay, thank you very much. But also, for today's giveaway, we are going to be giving away 500 more donator tickets, guys. And that's insane. If you guys liked it, make sure and follow the rules on the screen. Like the video, comment down below your Katagon IGN, and subscribe to the channel. Also, the winner of the last video's 500 are going up on the screen. Make sure and come online right now to claim your prize, or just comment on the video and I'll make sure and get back to you ASAP. Enjoy. Yo, and what is going on, guys? It's your boy Rekchu, and welcome back to another video. So, as you can tell right now, we are back on Katagon RSPS, guys. And today's video is going to be super hype, and I'm hoping it helps out a lot of people that come and join. Also, shout out to these guys right here showing me love, Carver319 and Apache. Really shout out to you guys. But anyways, guys, we're going to be doing a money-making guide on this server, and I really think it's going to be very tipful, so I hope you guys stay tuned all the way through and make sure and show some love. And if you guys missed yesterday's video, we actually did a server review on Katagon, and we kind of just showed off a lot of cool features and content and pretty much just went over the server and just like seeing what it was about. It's a great server though, so I really do recommend you guys coming and checking it out. Right now, they currently have 33 players online, which is very nice, guys. Make sure and click the link in the description and enjoy. First things first is thieving, as usual. This is like the first thing you do on any server, but pretty much you just want to stay here for a while and you can sell everything you get to this guy right here, Ali. But it's really recommended if you're an Iron Man to stay here until you're like 80 thieving. So you can come over here to the Scimitar stall and you can actually get the Dragon Scimitar here. It's a very easy way to do it. And also, once you come to the magic stall, I would recommend saving your battle staffs so you can just use those to do crafting as well. And that's recommended for Iron Man, but definitely come here to get some starter cash up so you can get some supplies and go like kill bosses. And that's when you can make the real money, you know what I mean? Okay, so we got 81k for all the rubies. We got 56k for all the emeralds, and we got 27k. So maybe about 170k-ish. From like 30 seconds of thieving, and then once I get to the Dragon Scimitar stall, those are going for like 71k each. Not too sure they're gonna sell for that, but if they do, you're gonna be making bank each inventory. Once you have thief for enough money to go buy some supplies, make sure and go do that. There we go, easy peasy. In about 2 minutes, we already have ourselves a nice gear set, but of course you're gonna have to get your like stats up first. You're not just gonna have stats right off the bat, but yeah, very nice, very easy, and we still have cash left over. You might need about 5 mil cash or so, so you might want to thieve for a little bit longer or do something else, but then come over here to the player-owned shop and buy yourself a bracelet of Ethereum. But you can just search up like the item you want, so we'll just go to View All Stores. I actually already know who's selling them. We'll go to this guy right here, and we'll just buy one of these, and we also need some ether. Yo, big shout out to Revenant Imp and also to Varg. Thank you so much. They both just gave me Revenant Ether for free. He gave me 2,000. He gave me like 1,762. So thank you so much. It's gonna help me out greatly. At this point, I'm pretty sure you guys know what I'm doing. I'm going to kill revenants, but they are in the wildies, so you gotta beware of PKers. So that's the only reason I'm buying food right now. Make sure you guys come prepared every time you go into the wilderness. Otherwise, you might get PK for your loot. Keep in mind, you are gonna need a revenant cave teleport in order to come here, and you can actually get these as a drop from the revenants. But also, make sure and charge your bracelet of Ethereum. I'm kind of low on food right now, so hopefully no PKers come here. Like, bruh, if they do, I'm just gonna fucking, like, shit myself. This guy just said, damn, just teleported into wild with, like, 500 mil risk. Yo, RIP to you. But yeah, guys, if you had this charged, you actually, like, won't get hit by this until you run out of your charges. So make sure, it's probably better to use range. I just came here with fucking melee, not knowing what I'm doing practically. But, you know, make sure and come here with the range, guys. Or melee, whatever works for you. But this guy's using range right now. He's level 39. Hey, at least we got a kill though, right? And we got ourselves some Revenant Ether. But yeah, you can get like tons of good drops here, guys. Make sure and come camp these out for some good loot. You can also get Wilderness Keys, Emblems, and a lot of noted resources. And look at that, like 6 kills down, we got ourselves a orange key. Now if we examine that, yo, can I pick it up real quick? And if we examine it, that is a tier 3, so not bad. We could probably get some decent loot out of that. Another thing very useful to use at the Revenants is a looting bag. You can get one from the Blood Money shop or from any monster in the wilderness. But if you have it, it's pretty much having like a second inventory on you at all times. It can be very useful. If you get bored of killing Revenants and you're looking for a good alternative, Slayer is definitely the place to go. They're also in the future going to be adding a Wilderness Slayer and also Boss Slayer task. So keep that in mind. But right now, Slayer is still very good to make money, and the shop looks very nice. They have all types of things in here, like fighter hats, fighter torsos, and you have a better chance on a Slayer task to get herb boxes as well as like coin caskets. So it's a very good thing to do, and just do this if you want to make money, and if you just like don't know what to do and you want to, you know, waste some time. By the way, you are able to get your Barrow's gloves here at the RDF minigame. Just come inside this room and talk to Gypsy. Now, if you come here, I would prefer using the Flames of Zamorak spell as well as charge. It'll go by a lot quicker, take about 5 minutes. Well, fuck me, I actually made it to the last stage and then I died, like, bruh. But once you complete it, make sure and come over here to the open chest and you can buy your Barrow's gloves out of here. Make sure you guys complete the Dwarf Cannon quest. If you do that, you'll actually get a cannon and it's very useful for all types of PVMing. No, feels bad. The evil tree is active right now at Draenor Village and the shooting star is inactive. But if you ever see either of these active, make sure and do these, guys. It's like the best way to get cash, resources, and XP when starting out on the game. But I do need 90 woodcutting, unfortunately, to do this, so I can't even do it right now. RIP. But yo, look at all these guys. They look really rich. It's probably from doing all these. Hello, YouTube's Kappa. Yo, what's going on, Lancer? Shout out to you, bro. Hands down, one of my favorite ways to make money on here is going to be the wilderness keys, guys. You can right click them and see like which tier they are. Now, the best tier is going to be the blue one. The lowest is going to be obviously the green. And just goes up from there. You can actually use these in the wilderness as well at Mage Bank. I'll go show you guys that real quick. I actually showed this off in yesterday's video, so if you didn't watch the video, make sure and go watch that once again. But here we are, come behind the Mage Bank and talk to Grandpa Jack, and he'll pretty much travel you into this like area right here, and you can run up here and use your wilderness keys and you'll get, you know, some good loot. But you can actually get these from killing like any boss in the server, like in the wilderness though, and you can actually get a chance at them. Look at luck to me, we got 150 blood money as well as a rune sword. RIP, no luck. Last but not least is of course bossing. Just right click your world map and it'll bring up a teleport interface. You can see all the bosses we offer here. We even offer Vorkath, Thora, all of them nice old school RuneScape bosses. We even have demonic gorillas and frost dragons. Make sure and come explore these. Check out the server and enjoy Katagon. Anyways guys, that is going to wrap it up for today's video. I hope you all enjoyed. Make sure and check out the Discord as well. I'll have the link in the description. We are hosting a 50 mil old school RuneScape GP like Discord invite event right now that I am actually being, you know, like currently, you know, trying to win. So, you know, go ahead and, you know, smack that freaking Discord link in the description. Help your boy wreck you out. And don't forget about today's giveaway of the 500 donator tickets. And of course, that rare box for the first comment. I hope you all enjoyed. I'll see you all next time and peace out.